Last time we figured out the area between two parabolas. Now let's see if we can generalize what we did to the area between any two curves. So here's the procedure. If you've got two curves, a higher curve and a lower curve, so we assume that f of x is bigger or equal to g of x on the interval that we're talking about, then I claim that the area between the curve y equals f of x and y equals g of x between a and b is the integral from a to b of the higher curve function minus the lower function dx. So here's a picture. We've got a higher curve y equals f of x, a lower curve y equals g of x, and somebody tells us we're going between this value of x and this value of x. And the way we did this is we chopped things up into pieces and we had to estimate the area of each piece. The area of each piece was roughly the height. Well, what's the height? It's f of x minus g of x. And then we multiply that by the width. The width of each piece is delta x. So we get that the total area is roughly the sum of all of those pieces. And strictly speaking, we should say which x? This x, and then this x, and then this x, and then this x. So we're really summing of f of xi minus g of xi times delta x. And in the limit, this becomes the integral from a to b of f of x minus g of x dx. So for example, let's suppose we wanted to find the area between the curve y equals e to the x, and y equals x minus 3, and x equals 0, and x equals 2. Now let's draw a picture of that. Y equals e to the x looks like this, and y equals x minus 3 looks like that. And we want to find the area of this region in here. So we have, our formula says we have to do the integral from 0 to 2 of the function on top minus the function on the bottom, dx. And we know how to do that. That's the integral from 0 to 2 of e to the x plus 3 minus x dx. And that gives us e to the x plus 3x minus x squared over 2 evaluated at 0 and at 2. So that gives us e squared plus 6 minus 2 minus 1. And that's e squared plus 3. Okay, that area is e squared plus 3. But now what happens if we have a situation where one of the curves starts out bigger and then winds up being smaller? So for example, if we want to understand the area of this bow tie shaped region between the curve y equals x and the curve y equals 1 minus x between x equals 0 and x equals 1, well, how can we do that with integrals? Well, when we chop things up into slices, over in this part, we're taking the big curve, that's 1 minus x, divided by the little curve. So these intersect at the point 1 half, 1 half. So this region, let's call this R1. The area of R1 is the integral from 0 to a half of the bigger curve minus a smaller curve dx. The area of the other region, let's call it R2, is the integral from 1 half to 1. Now the bigger function is x. The smaller function is 1 minus x. Okay. In both cases, you know how to do the integrals. This is the integral of 1 minus 2x from 0 to a half. So that's x minus x squared evaluated at 0 and a half. And that gives us a quarter. And this integral also works out to a quarter. Okay. So in general, you always want the higher minus the lower, but if the curves cross, then you're going to have to take the higher minus lower over the first section, and then there's a different higher and a different lower over the second section. The next problem involves finding the area between two curves where nobody told you what the x values were. If nobody tells you what the x values are, you've got to figure out what the x values are. We're trying to figure out the area of this region, and we need limits of integration, so we need to figure out for what value of x do these guys meet, and for what value of x do these guys meet over here. So how do you find the point of intersection of two curves? You set the functions equal. You solve x squared equals x plus 2, or x squared minus x minus 2 equals 0. And we've got a formula for that. The quadratic formula tells us that x is 1 plus or minus the square root of 1 plus 8 over 2. So that's 1 plus or minus 3 over 2. So that's either 2 or negative 1. So this point here is at x equals 2. In fact, it's the point 2, 4. 2 squared is 4, and 2 plus 2 is 4. And this is the point negative 1, 1. Negative 1 squared is 1. Negative 1 plus 2 is 1. So now we know that our starting value is negative 1, is x equals negative 1. Our ending value is 2. And our area winds up being the integral from negative 1 to 2 of the top curve minus the bottom curve dx. And that is x squared over 2 plus 2x minus x cubed over 3, evaluated at negative 1 and at 2. We plug in 2, we get 4 squared over 2 is 2, twice 2 is 4, minus 8 thirds. That's what we get when we plug in 2. When we plug in negative 1, we get 1 half minus 2 plus 1 third. Put it all together, and we get, let's see, 6 minus 8 thirds, that's 18 thirds minus 8 thirds, that's 10 thirds minus, oh boy, 10 thirds minus 1 third makes 9 thirds, that's 3, plus 2 makes 5, minus a half makes 4 and a half, so this is 9 halves.